Cameras present a scene from a particular point of view. The camera position impacts on the way we interpret a scene. An eye-level view is a neutral position. A bird's eye view gives us an overview of the layout, while close-ups help us highlight details of our design. This file contains the bedroom we were working on in the previous video, the render setup, but in this file, there are no cameras, since we will place them together now. Go to the Chaos Corona toolbar and click on the first icon, Create Corona Camera. Go to the top viewport, click, and hold in front of the back wall to place the camera. Drag the mouse and where you release it the camera target is placed. Let me repeat it, not just click, but click and hold it. Drag the cursor and where you release it the target is placed. To delete this camera, simply click on the delete button from the keyboard. Another way, if you are not using the Corona toolbar, is to use the command panel. Go to the command panel, click on the create tab and then choose cameras. With the standard category selected, click on Corona Cam from the object type rollout. After placing the camera, the first thing we need to do is to change one of the viewports to show the camera's view. To do so, click in the perspective window to activate it, then click on the viewport's name label, perspective, and from the drop-down menu select cameras. The camera's submenu appears and shows the name of every camera in the scene. Select Corona Camera 001, since for now, we only have one camera. The viewport now shows the Corona Camera 001 point of view. At a first glance, the point of view we get in our example looks odd, since one would expect to see the interior of the bedroom. The reason the point of view looks like this is because anything we create in 3ds Max is placed at a height of 0 centimeters. So, if we go to the front or the left viewport and check where the camera is positioned, we will see that it is basically placed in the floor. So, the next step is to select and elevate the Corona Camera 001. When you go from one viewport to another, always right-click to activate the viewport. This way your selected object remains selected. If you left-click, the new viewport will be activated, but your object gets deselected. Going back to the camera we created, a Corona camera consists of two elements, the camera and the camera target, and those two are connected to each other with a line. When the Corona camera is selected, we can also see the field of view, which is the area inside this triangle. If we deselect the camera, here are a few ways on how to select it. Press the H key on your keyboard. The Select from Scene dialog box appears, which shows in alphabetical order all the objects in the scene. Scroll down to find and select the camera or the target. If you want to select both, choose one of them and then select the other one by holding the Control key. Then click the OK button. Another way is to click on the camera's viewport name label, Corona Camera 001, and from the drop-down menu choose Select Camera or Select Camera Target. And a third way is to click, directly from the viewports, on the camera or on the camera target. If we click on the line that connects the two, then they both get selected. Sometimes it is difficult to select a camera from the viewports because other objects are on top of it. An easy way to select specific types is by using the selection filter from the main toolbar. The selection filter list lets us restrict the selection to specific categories. When the selection filter is all, we can select all the objects from the scene. If, for instance, we click on all and choose cameras, then we can select only cameras from the viewports and the other objects in the scene freeze. If you select the camera and go to the command panel, you see in the name and color field that the camera is automatically named Corona Camera 001, while if you select the target it is named Corona Camera 001, Target. By selecting both the camera and the target, the name and color input changes to one camera selected. Now that we have placed the camera, we see its point of view in the viewport and we have selected it, it's time to adjust its position. There are two different ways that we can do that, using the transform commands or using the camera navigation controls. To activate the select and move command we can do one of the following. Click on the select and move command from the main toolbar, or press the W key on the keyboard. Right-click and choose move from the quad menu. Click on the Y axis, the green arrow, and dragged the Corona Camera 001 higher. The Corona Camera 001 viewport updates as we are adjusting the position of the camera. If we want to place the camera at a specific height, let's say at 120 centimeters, we need to use the coordinate display in the status bar. More specifically, select the camera, go to the Z field down here and type 120. Then select the camera target, and do the same, which means, go to the Z field and type 120. Now both the camera and the target are placed at 120 centimeters. Make sure Show Safe Frames is enabled. When we see the camera viewport, we only see a zoomed part of the bedroom, but this is something that we will deal with shortly. We have completed placing the camera using the Select and Move command. So now we will see how we can achieve the same result using the camera viewport controls. Let's select and delete this camera and place it from scratch. Go to the cameras, click on the Corona Cam, go to the top viewport, click, hold and drag to place the camera and where you will leave it the target is placed. Go to the perspective viewport, click on the perspective and choose cameras, Corona Camera 001. The viewport changes to the Corona Camera 001. As we said before, when we place a camera, it is by default placed at height 0 cm, so the next step is to elevate it. At the bottom left corner of the 3ds Max window are the buttons that control the display and navigation of the viewports. The navigation controls change depending on the active viewport. When we change to a camera view, the navigation controls change to the camera viewport controls. With the Corona Camera 001 viewport active, click on the second command from the bottom row, Truck Camera. This command allows us to move both the camera and the camera target parallel to the view plane. Since we only want to adjust the height of the camera, press and hold down the Shift key to constrain the movement and drag the mouse higher, parallel to the Z axis. If here, you don't see the Truck command, click and hold down, and you will see three commands to pop up. Select Truck Camera. While you use the navigation controls for a camera viewport, hold down the Shift key to constrain the movement to be vertical or horizontal. You do not need to have the camera or the camera target selected to use the Truck Camera command. Use the Dolly Camera plus Target command to move the camera along its main axis, toward or away from what the camera is pointing at. If you hold down the Dolly Camera button, a flyout menu appears. You can select to either move the camera, Dolly Camera, or its target, Dolly Target, or both Dolly Camera plus Target. The Truck and the Dolly commands are basically the ones I use to adjust the camera's position. From the navigation controls, there are two more commands that I use all the time, the last two. If you click on the Maximize Viewport command, you can maximize the active viewport and see it better. If you click again, you return to the four window layout. And then there is the Zoom Extends All Selected command. Select for instance the bed and click on the Zoom Extends All Selected command. The viewports zoom in to the selected object. Well, all the viewports apart from the camera viewport, which has a still point of view. If we go to the top viewport to see where the camera is located, we will see that it is placed right in front of the wall. Although we have placed it at the very back of the room, we only see a zoomed part of it. To capture more, the first setting we will adjust is the focal length of the camera. Select the camera, go to the Modify tab in the command panel to see the camera settings. Please be careful, to see the camera settings in the Modify tab, we need to select only the camera, not the camera target or both. Go to the Photographic Parameters rollout. In the sensor and lens section, we define how wide the angle of the view will be. Personally, I use the focal length. The lower this value, the wider the angle. The default value is 40 millimeters. Type 30 and press enter. If we see the camera viewport, we get the illusion that we stepped back, but we did not move the camera, the lens of the camera got wider. Try 20 and press enter. Now, we have a better understanding of the room design, since we can clearly see all three walls. The lower the focal length, the more items it captures, but at the same time, the scene starts to look distorted. The objects in the foreground look bigger than what they are in reality. I usually avoid using focal length values lower than 30 to avoid any distortion of the scene. I will keep the default value of 40mm for our example, and to have a better overview of the room, we will use the camera clipping. When the camera is selected, we see the field of view, which is this white triangle, and that helps us understand which parts of the scene are visible in the camera viewport. You can see that this triangle now doesn't contain the curtains or the hanging clothes. If we want to see them, we need to push the camera further back, approximately somewhere here. But when we push the camera that back, we are now behind the wall, so the only thing we see in the camera viewport is this wall. But that's fine, because the next step is to activate the camera clipping. With the Corona Camera 001 selected, go to the Modify tab in the command panel. Scroll down and open the Environment and Clipping Rollout. Check both the Enable and the Show in Viewport checkboxes. Camera clipping allows us to exclude some of the scene's geometry and view only a certain portion of the scene. This portion is controlled by the near and the far values. As their name denotes, in the near value we set the distance from the camera where we start to see, and in the far value, we set the distance from the camera till where we stop seeing from that point after. More specifically, if we type 100 centimeters in the near value, a plane, a white line appears that indicates the starting point of the camera. At 100 centimeters, I'm still outside the house, so I will increase more the near value, until the near clipping plane is located in front of the wall. At approximately 200 centimeters, I can now see the interior of the bedroom, although our camera is out. Isn't this great? This feature is super useful, especially in small rooms like bathrooms, to be able to capture the full room. If we zoom out, we also see the far clipping plane. We don't care what this value is, as long as the far clipping plane is located outside the room to include it all. If, for instance, we decrease the far value and place the far plane inside the room, let's say at 500 centimeters, you can see the result we get. In the camera viewport, it is visible only the part of the scene that is between the near and far planes. Let's increase the far value to include the full room. One thing you should be careful of is that if the clipping plane intersects an object, it cuts through that object, and it will render the cut part black. So that you can understand that, select the camera and increase the near value. Now it cuts the bed, the rug and the floor, and if we render, you see these parts black. Let's readjust the near value. Now the camera and the camera target are both placed at the same height. Let's see what happens if we place them at different heights. More specifically, let's say that we want to see more of the floor. To do so, we need to select the camera target. Click on the name of the viewport, Corona Camera 001, and choose Select Camera Target. Click on the blue arrow which represents the Z-axis and drag the mouse downwards. What we see is that the view gets distorted. To avoid this, we need to enable the automatic tilt. Press undo to return to the original target position. Select the camera and go to its properties. Scroll down to find the tilt and shift rollout and enable the automatic vertical tilt. The view no longer gets distorted. Now that we have set the camera, let's produce a render to see what we get. Next step is to go to the Post tab in the Frame Buffer window and play with the settings we mentioned in the previous video. In simple terms, depth of field allows us to focus on an object and blurs out the rest of the scene. Let's set another camera that will focus on the left nightstand. We can either create a new camera from scratch, or we can copy the one we have already placed. To do so, select the camera and the target by clicking on the line that connects them. Enable the Select and Move command. Hold down the Shift key and drag the camera. A copy of the camera is created. When you leave the cursor, the Clone Options window appears. If we choose Copy, we create a copy of the camera that is a separate clone from the original. Modifying one has no effect on the other. If we choose Instance, we create an interchangeable clone of the original. If we modify the instanced object, let's say its film width, the original object will automatically change as well. The Refence option is a bit more complicated, and I'll explain it later. In this case, we will select Copy since we don't want the two cameras to have identical settings. Go to the Corona Camera 001 viewport and choose to see the Corona Camera 002 point of view. I will move the camera closer to the nightstand and then I will go to its settings and disable the clipping planes. I will adjust its position until I'm satisfied with the result. To enable DOF, go to the camera settings and to the DOF and motion blur rollout. Check the Enable box in the Depth of Field section. If we press Render, although we have enabled the DOF, we don't see any of the objects in the scene in focus. That's because first we need to do some adjustments. Select the target and move it where the books are. The F number is the setting that controls the blurriness of the image in combination with the position of the camera and the target. High F number means crisp renders and low F number means blurred renders. Let's set the F number to 1.2 and render. Now, the area of focus is the book. The foreground is blurred out and also the background. The elements behind the camera target get blurry as well. Only the books are crisp. If we select the camera target and push it further back, let's say at the wall lamp and render, now the point of focus is the wall lamp, and all the foreground gets blurry, including the books this time. The more we increase the F number, the crispier the render. If instead of 1.2, we make it 2, the less blurry the area out of focus will be. At F number 16, which was the default value, everything looks sharp. So, when you want to use DOF, first adjust the position of your target and then play with the F number to control how strong the DOF will be. Instead of changing the camera target, you can go to the camera settings. Enable the Override Focus option, and set where the point of focus is through the value field. So here, the point of focus will be the books, while now it will be the wall lamp. That's all with the cameras, and now we are ready to move on to the natural lighting of a scene.